The last class we all have made compost. As you know that compost is very important for the plant growth, right? So now in this activity we are going to make organic as well as the inorganic pesticide. And we should know that what is pesticide. You have seen that sometime when we are growing our plants in our garden, there are certain pests, there are certain insects as well as there are certain microbes that are attacking our plants. As you can see, these plants are attacked by certain microbes. Some pest may be attacking on them and the growth of the plant is stopped. Okay? So what we can do in order to save our plants from these pests, from these insects or from these microbes? Okay? So the best way that we are having some common things that are present in our surrounding, we can take that and we can make a natural or organic pesticide. As well as there are certain chemicals available that we can also use for making the pesticide, right? So let us do the first activity for making the pesticide. So first of all, we will start with organic things. Like we are having the neem leaves. Neem leaves are the best organic pesticide. So how to make the pesticide from the neem leaves? You all will take these neem leaves, okay? You will boil the water. As you can see, we have already started the boiling process. I'll put these leaves, these neem leaves in this boiling water. I will boil these for 10 to 15 minutes. Okay. After taking out this boiling process, we will cool down. So now you can see that the color of these leaves is extracted with the help of this boiling water. So we will allow this liquid to cool for some time. And after that, we will do the filtration of this. After filtration, we will take this liquid as a pesticide, but that will be diluted. So let us cool it down till we are just showing the preparation of some other pesticide. So I am keeping it here, right? So next thing that we are having in our kitchen, the most important, that is the baking soda. It is present in everyone's kitchen, right? So we will take just pinch of this baking soda and we will add it in water. Like this, we will add it in water. As now I added the baking soda in this water, okay, I am dissolving it, mixing it. Now this solution is prepared. What we will do, we will dilute this solution up to 500 ml or up to 1000 ml, okay. So in this beaker I took the water, I will just add more water into it so that a dilute solution can be prepared. Okay, so now this solution can be used as a pesticide. And this is best pesticide to kill the insects, to kill the pests as well as the microbes like the fungi that are attacking our plants. Okay, we can fill this liquid in this spray bottle and we can spray the liquid on the plants. Like this we can spray the liquid here, right? So this is our first one. Next important thing that is present in our home, that is the vinegar. Okay, this is the acetic acid, but it is the vinegar that we are using it. It can also be used as a best pesticide, the organic pesticide. Again, what we will do, we will take some amount of it and we will just dilute this. Like this, we will take like 5 or 10 ml of this and we will dilute it by putting more water. Dilute solution of vinegar is also acting as a best pesticide, right? Next important thing that we are having in our kitchen, that is the common salt, sodium chloride, the common salt. Okay, we can also use this common salt as a pesticide by making the dilute solution of this. You can also sprinkle it. So again, a pinch of this salt can be added in a beaker. It will be dissolved in water. You can take the warm water for mixing it. So like this, I'll add some water into it. Let us firstly mix this. After mixing, we all will dilute it. Now, this will be mixed with the help of this glass roll. And this solution will be mixing. Okay, we will dilute this solution again up to 500 ml or 1000 ml. this is dissolved, we are adding more of the water into it. Now, this is our third pesticide, that is the common soil solution. It can also be used for sprinkling on some plants. After this, one more is there, that is the copper sulfate. It can be available in the market, the solution, but we can prepare here. So in this beaker, I have already took some water. I'll add a pinch of copper sulfate. This is blue in color. Okay. So this blue color solution is added. This blue color salt is actually added into water. Mix again. So now we have to dilute this. 500 ml. So this blue color solution, that is the copper sulfate solution. This is our another pesticide. It is having the best properties for the fungal infection. If some fungus is attacking on our plants, these can be killed with the help of this by spraying this solution. Next, we are having here the borax. Is helping to remove the ants that are attacking on the plants. Okay, so we are not preparing a solution, but we will just sprinkle this. The solid, salt will be sprinkled on the soil near the plant, right? So if some ants or some worms are there, so they will not come near to our plants. So we will not water our plant for at least 24 hours. So in this way, we have to add this natural pesticide into the soil, and this is added in the solid form, not in the liquid form, right? One more thing that we are having here, that is our calcium oxide. We are calling it as the chuna, generally we are calling it, okay? So this is also added to the soil. In case some ants are there, some worms are there, so they can also be repelled with the help of this. So this is also added in the form of solid. Like this is our plant, we can add this near to the base, so the plants will be kept safe from some microbes, from some ants, worms or the pests by using this calcium oxide also, right? Now one more is there, that is the hydrogen peroxide. This is actually a liquid. We can also make a natural pesticide with the help of this liquid, and this is again just similar to others like the vinegar. It is just transparent in color, okay? So we can also make its own pesticide, right? So now you all can see, like, our this neem leaves are little bit getting cool. So let us filter it and prepare our natural pesticide. So on this tripod stand, this funnel is kept. In this funnel, we put a filter paper. With the help of filter paper, you can see that the liquid is pouring out and the leaves are remaining on its top, right? So this beaker is almost filled. So let us take the extra one in this beaker. Okay, so this is our neem leaf waters, okay, that we have extracted from after boiling the neem leaves. So we have to add it into water. Again, we have to dilute it, because dilute solution is required. If you will add a concentrated solution, it has bad effects or adverse effect on our plants. Our plants cannot grow properly, okay, if we are adding the concentrated. So we have to dilute each kind of the pesticide solution. Right? Let us dilute it up to 500 ml, okay. Now, what we have to do, we have to add it in our spraying bottle. After adding it into the spraying bottle, we have to check the spray. But we will not spray this into whole of the plant. In a particular area, first of all, we will test. Like in one leaf, we can test. Okay? And you have to observe it. In case, if there is no effect, no harmful effect, then you have to sprinkle it over whole of the plant. But if some harmful effect, like if the leaves are shrinking or and they are getting spoiled, you will not add. At that condition, you have to again dilute it, right? So this is just the area testing. We are doing the test with the help of these pesticides. So hope you all will enjoy. You can also save your plants by using some of the natural pesticides at your home. Okay. So hope you all enjoyed this activity. I'm expecting that you all.